हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। आई एम डॉक्टर सोनिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन, अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज, इंदौर। टुडे वी विल सी द इंट्रोडक्शन टू प्रिवेंटिव मेडिसिन मेथड्स इन ऑब्स्टेट्रिक मेटर्निटी साइकिल एंड मेटर्नल एंड चाइल्ड हेल्थ प्रोग्राम, एंड वी आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द एंटीनेटल केयर। Now, preventive medicine and obstetric. The obstetrics is concerned with the aim of ensuring good health of the mother throughout pregnancy, puerperium, and that every pregnancy may culminate in a healthy mother and a healthy baby. This has given rise to a new concept called social obstetrics, which deals with the social and environmental factors and human reproduction going back to the preconception or premarital period. Preventive medicine in obstetrics, antenatal care, intranatal care, and postnatal care. Now, antenatal care, what is antenatal care? Just we are going to quickly see. This period begins soon after pregnancy and continues throughout the pregnancy. The objectives are to promote, protect, and maintain health during pregnancy, detect the high-risk cases and give attention, foresee preventable complications, remove anxiety and dread associated with delivery, reduce maternal and infant mortality and morbidity, teach the mother elements of child care, nutrition, personal hygiene and environmental sanitation, educate the mother about the family planning, medical termination of pregnancy. So these are the various objectives for antenatal care. Okay. Then antenatal care delivery includes antenatal visits, which we see, that is minimum and maximum visits, the prenatal advice, specific health protection, mental preparation, family planning and pediatric component. So all these are the antenatal care delivery, right? Intranatal care is the care which is taken during childbirth, okay? Objectives are through asepsis, minimal injury to the mother and child, dealing with complications such as prolonged labor, antepartum hemorrhage, convulsions, malpresentations, prolapse of the cord, etc. Care of baby during delivery, resuscitation, care of cord, care of eyes. So these are the objectives: through asepsis, minimum injury to mother and child, dealing with the complications such as prolonged labor, antepartum hemorrhage, convulsions, malpresentation, prolapse of the cord, etc. Care of baby during delivery, resuscitation, care of the cord, care of eyes, etc. Then domiciliary care. The mothers with normal obstetric history may be advised to have their confinement in their own homes. Delivery may be conducted by the health worker female or a trained DAI. It is also known as the domiciliary midwife service. Okay, so those mothers who have a good obstetric history, they may be advised to have their confinement at home only, and these deliveries can be conducted by a female health worker or with the help of trained DAI, and this is known as domiciliary midwife service. Institutional care, about 1% of the deliveries tend to be abnormal, 4% difficult, thus requiring the services of the doctors. Institutional care is recommended for all high-risk cases. The mother is allowed to rest for one day after delivery and discharged after 5 days. Rooming in. Keeping the baby's crib by the mother's side is called rooming in. Okay, I hope I am clear with it. This arrangement gives the mother to know her baby and also gives a sense of security. There are high chances of success in the breastfeeding. Postnatal care kya hai? It is the care of the mother and the newborn after delivery. Okay, after delivery is postnatal, intra is during delivery, and antenatal is during delivery, that is before your delivery. Care of the mother is primarily the responsibility of the obstetrician, and the care of newborn is the combined responsibility of the obstetrician as well as the pediatrician. Care of mother: prevent complications of postnatal period, provide care for rapid restoration of mother to optimum health, check adequacy of breastfeeding, provide family planning advice, provide basic health education to the mother and the family. Now, maternity cycle: fertilization, antenatal period, intranatal period, postnatal period, and fertilization you have interconceptional period. So fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube. Segmentation proceeds at a rapid rate. The fertilized ovum reaches the uterus in 8 to 10 days. Organs and tissues are formed by cell division and differentiation. Prenatal period. Ovum 0 to 14 days. Embryo 14 days to 9 weeks. Fetus from 9th week to birth. Premature infant is 28 to 37 weeks. Full term birth is 280 days on an average. So, ये हमें याद रखना चाहिए और ये सब हम लोग बायोलॉजी में पढ़ चुके हैं, ठीक है? Ovum 0 to 14 days. Embryo 14 days to 9 weeks. Fetus 9 week to birth. And premature infant 28 days to 37 weeks. Full term birth 280 days on an average. Child health problems which we are going to see subsequently in this chapter are LBW, low birth weight, that is less than 2.5 kg, malnutrition, infections and parasitosis, accidents and poisoning, behavioral problems. This we are going to subsequently see. Then coming to this slide, it's an important slide denoting evaluation of maternal and child health programs in India. 1952 Family Planning Program adopted by the Government of India. 1961 Department of Family Planning created in the Ministry of Health. 71 MTP Act. 77 Renaming of Family Planning to Family Welfare. 78 Expanded Program on Immunization. 1985 we have Universal Immunization Program plus National Oral Rehydration Therapy Program. 1992 Child Survival and Safe Motherhood Program. 1996 Target Free Approach. 1997 Reproductive and Child Health Program 1. 2005 Reproductive and Child Health Program 2. So these are the various milestones and few of them you can just go through it. Ki 1952 se story chalu hui family planning se, 61 mein family planning ka department bana, 71-72 mein MTP Act aya, 77 mein renaming of family planning to family welfare hua, then expanded program on immunization 78, 85 mein UIP, that is universal immunization program, 92 mein child survival and safe motherhood, 96 में टारगेट फ्री अप्रोच, 97 में RCH1 एंड 2005 में आया RCH2. सो दीज आर द वेरियस माइलस्टोन्स विच यू शुड टेक केयर ऑफ इन द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ MCH प्रोग्राम. नाउ मैटरनल हेल्थ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट, इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू वेरियस थिंग्स विच यू आर गोइंग टू टेक केयर. फर्स्ट इज द एसेंशियल ऑब्स्टेट्रिक केयर. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अर्ली रजिस्ट्रेशन 12 टू 16 वीक्स, 3 antenatal checkups, prevention and treatment of anemia, institutional and safe deliveries and postnatal checkup. So this is essential obstetric care which has to be taken care and which has to be included in every female's life. Second is emergency obstetric care. It consists of establishment of first referral units, that is FRUs, at sub-district level health institutions. 1748 FRUs were identified by the states. 13 different types of equipment were provided for carrying out procedures like laparotomy, C-section, blood transfusion, newborn care and anesthesia management. 24 hours delivery services at the PSCs and CSC, okay, so that 24 hours institutional deliveries can be provided. Then improve the institutional delivery by upgradation of labor rooms in the PSC. Funds for 24-hour delivery services at the PSC, involvement of private sector, gynecologists, lady doctors on hiring basis for visiting PSCs on the weekly basis. So, ye char ho gaye, essential obstetric care, emergency obstetric care which will include first referral unit, 24 hours delivery services at the PSC CSC and improvement of the institutional delivery. Fir hota hai referral transport. That is at the time of transport when it is required at the time of obstetric emergencies. Phir hota hai MTP, where you have to, means what are the indications where you are required to do the MTP. Then prevention, management and control of RTI, that is reproductive tract infections, and integrated financial envelope. This was the part 1. of this class. Now we are going to start, that is the antenatal care. So maternity cycle, as we have already discussed, it includes the fertilization, the antenatal or the prenatal period, the intranatal period, the postnatal period and the interconceptional period. Antenatal care means care of women during the pregnancy. Objectives are to ensure a normal pregnancy with delivery of a healthy baby from a healthy mother. Antenatal care comprises of, first is the registration of pregnancy, history taking, proper antenatal examinations including both general as well as the obstetrical examination, lab investigations, health education. Now what are the objectives? Why we are doing the antenatal care? To promote, protect and maintain the health of the mother. Teach the mother the elements of child health, child care, nutrition, personal hygiene and environmental sanitation. Remove anxiety and dread about pregnancy. Then complications you have to remove. You have to detect the high risk cases and you have to reduce the maternal morbidity, mortality. And last is sensitization of the mother to the need of family planning, including the advice to the cases seeking MTP. Okay, so these are the various objectives why we have to take care of the mother during the antenatal period. First visit, if the patient comes to you, you are going to do the history taking. That is, you are going to take proper history starting from the last menstrual period, calculating the expected date of delivery, then advising about the diet, the diet, nutrition, the proper sleep, proper bowel bladder method, then what all investigations are to be done, then what examination like the BP, pulse, all this you are going to take care in the first visit itself. So see, here are the points written: history taking, the particulars of the patient, chief complaints with the duration, past history, obstetric history, menstrual history, family history, drug history, history of immunization, socioeconomic history, contraceptive history and history of allergy. ANC visits, if you talk about, ideally 13 visits are there. First 7 months once a month, next month, that is in the 8th month, you have to go twice a month, and in the last month you have to go weekly. Okay, so these are the 13 ANC visits which should be followed ideally. But if somebody is unable to follow that, then minimum 4 antenatal visits should be at least given. Like first visit within 12 weeks or as soon as the pregnancy is confirmed. Second visit is between 13 and 26 weeks. Third visit is between 27 to 34 weeks. And fourth visit is between 36 weeks and the term. This is the MCP card which is provided by the government under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Okay, it takes care about the antenatal visit, the examinations, the reports, everything is written in this card. Mother and Child Protection Card, yahan details aa jayenge mother ke, aur jo main pehle page dikhaya tha usme sare status aa jayega ki kab kab kaun sa tika laga, kaun si dawai li. Physical examination will include to see about the pelor, the weight of the mother, pulse, edema, breast examination, respiratory rate and the blood pressure. Examination, the pelor, examine the palpebral conjunctiva, nails, tongue, oral mucosa and the palms. Pulse should be 60 to 90 per minute. Respiratory rate should be 18 to 20 breaths per minute and you have to look for edema. BP, 2 consecutive readings should be done. Systolic, more than 140 mmHg or diastolic, more than 90 mmHg, they should be seen for. Okay, it should be normal, 110 or 120-80. Check urine for the presence of albumin, preeclampsia. Watch for hypertension plus albuminuria. Diastolic, more than 110, it is alarming. Eclampsia will be, preeclampsia is hypertension plus albuminuria imminent eclampsia minus diastolic more than 110 mmHg. Eclampsia will be hypertension plus albuminuria plus convulsions. Regular weight monitoring at each visit and 9 to 11 kgs of weight gain in the entire pregnancy. After first trimester, weight gain will be 2 kgs per month. Breast examination, you have to do the size and shape of the nipples. Then abdominal examination, measurement of the fundal height, the fetal heart sounds, fetal movements, fetal parts, multiple pregnancy, fetal lie and presentation, inspection of abdominal scar or any other relevant findings. So these are the abdominal examination. Lab investigations will include HB estimation, blood and RH grouping, rapid malaria test, urine testing for albumin and sugar, VDRL, RPR testing, HIV testing, blood sugar testing and HBsAg testing. Abdominal we have seen. Then regular weight monitoring at each visit, 9 to 11 kgs entire pregnancy, after first trimester weight gain 2 kgs per month. Okay, lab bhi dekh liya. Phir risk approach mein elderly primary 30 years and more, short stature 140 cm and below. Look for malpresentations, look for antepartal hemorrhage, threatened abortion, preeclampsia and eclampsia. This will be the risk approach. Then continued here, anemia, twin pregnancies, hydramnios, IUFD, stillbirth, elderly grand, multiparas, prolonged pregnancy, history of past cesarean or instrumental delivery, treatment for infertility. Then in subsequent visits, you have to look for the patient's complaint. You have to see the general examination, gestational age to be calculated, identification of problem, fetal movement, health education, profile access and treatment of anemia, developing the individualized birth plan. Second visit will be between 24 to 28 weeks. You have to see the fundal height and you have to detect the multiple pregnancies. Third visit will be at 32 weeks. Screen for preeclampsia, multiple pregnancy, anemia and IUGR. Fourth visit will be at 36 weeks. Identification of fetal lie, presentation, position and update the birth plan. Antenatal advice will be entire pregnancy 300 kilocalories per day extra. Lactation 0 to 6 months 600 kilocalories per day. Lactation 6 to 12 months 520 kilocalories per day. Diet, supplementary iron therapy is needed for all pregnant mothers from 20 weeks onwards. 30 mg of ferrous per day. 60 to 100 mg per day is given for large women, twin pregnancy and those who book for ANC in the late pregnancy. Anemic women should take 200 mg per day. Hygiene, daily bathing is recommended. As it is stimulation, refreshing and relaxing, avoid very hot water bath. Bowel care, as there is increase in the chance of constipation, regular bowel movement may be facilitated by regulation of diet such as plenty of food, fluids, vegetables and milk. Breast care, wash the breast and clean tap water with clean tap water. Exercise, walk in moderation, avoid lifting heavy things, avoid long term standing, avoid sitting with the crossed legs as this may interrupt in the circulation. Dressing tight clothes, use of belts are avoided. Patient should wear loose and comfortable dresses. High heel shoes are also avoided. Alcohol, smoking and drugs should be avoided for the fetal well-being because it will affect the fetal well-being. Rest and sleep, 8 hours sleep in the night and at least 2 hours sleep in the afternoon after the meal. Hard strenuous work should be avoided in the first trimester and in the last 4 weeks. Then coitus, it is written here, should be avoided in first trimester and in the last 6 weeks. Warning signs, if you look here, where you have to go to the doctor, they are headache, blurring of vision, convulsions, vaginal bleeding, fever. So that's all in the antenatal care. I hope I am clear with the video. If you have any doubt, please come through your queries. In the second part, we are going to come with the new topics of MCH. Thank you. Have a nice day.